Antimicrobial resistance is accelerated by the misuse and overuse of antibiotics, as well as poor infection prevention and control. According to the Director of Product Safety at the National Drug Authority, Dr. Helen Biomire-Ndagije, antimicrobial resistance ranks second among the leading causes of death in Uganda. If not averted, it is projected to cause 10 million deaths worldwide by 2050, thus a major concern.
If we first tested and understood what is the issue of the fever, and then the underlying cause, and then that you can do by going to a healthcare professional.
If we do not intervene, the health impact of antimicrobial resistance is projected to cause 10 million deaths worldwide by the year 2050, while the global loss of capital caused by antimicrobial resistance is estimated to be approximately $300 billion. To 1 trillion by 2050.
Among the leading drivers of antimicrobial resistance is self-medication, but also stakeholders say that poverty among the public leaves them with no option but to take underdoses of which they can capably foot bills for.
Because when you look at the drivers for antimicrobial resistance, one of them is self-medication. People thinking, because I have a fever, like last time I had a fever, so you go and pick the same medication. When, for instance, you take antibiotics.
Antimicrobial resistance, considered as the next pandemic in Uganda, has to be averted using a One Health approach. Leaders say that there is still need to develop a plan that clearly guides better communication approaches.
The health sector in particular has completely changed its focus to community engagement, health promotion and disease prevention. And we are collectively, under the One Health framework, educating the population majorly about prevention as well as prevention antimicrobial resistance.
To effectively tackle AMR, therefore, requires One Health response that recognizes the health of humans, of course, but also the health of animals, including domesticated and wild animals.
In 2015, 37% of all hospital admissions in Uganda were due to microbial infections, mainly pneumonia and TB. These infections were associated with high rates of antimicrobial resistance and accounted for 18.4% of all deaths among hospitalized patients. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.